So what do we got here? We got the Verde Imperial Stout from Italy. All right, it expires in 2016. Sorry, I got that wrong. I thought it was 2015, but it's the 15th day of the 5th month of the 16th year. 2016, that is. That's what I figure, anyway. 8.2% alcohol by volume. Verde Imperial Stout. This is the European Beer Star Award winner for the Best Tasting Gold Award of 2008. The ingredients list is aqua, malto di orzo, avena, lapulia, levito, and spezie. Okay, so there's a few more ingredients than water, barley, malt, and hops, right? We got aqua, meaning water, I would imagine. Malto di orzo, I'm guessing barley malt. Avena, I'm going to guess that's hops, I have no idea. Lapulia, I don't know what that is. Levito, I think that's like leaven, like yeast. And spezie, I think that's spices. So I think there's coffee and spices in this beer, basically. Flat out. Could be totally wrong. That could be... That shit could be like salt and who knows what. I have no idea what that... I cannot read Italian. There's no way. No way. This is a great beer to review, you know, seeing as it's all the way from Italy in a 330-milliliter bottle. This was almost $11 up here in Canada, so it wasn't cheap, but I thought, damn, it's got an award. It's got to be good, right? I don't know. I've had a glass already, and it was a cooler temperature, so this is the warmer review. That head looks damn fine. You know what I'm saying? All right. It's richening up. I'm getting a little more alcohol at this temperature. It's a little warmer, a little bit more foamy. I'm smelling the foam, you know what I'm saying? I'm not getting as much plum out of it as in the aroma anyway as before. Yeah, definitely let this one warm up a little bit more. It's almost got a slight little bit of licorice note now in the back. And what I assume to be either spices or some kind of insane amount of char stout grains has subsided a lot. Because before I was getting like a chili burn down my throat and into my intestines. Like my stomach was burning. So... Let it warm up, because I think too cold, it's just way too harsh. The carbonation was really insane, and so I said, you know what? And it wasn't that cold. Like, I'd let it warm up for a while. At least 40 minutes out of the fridge, so... And it's a little bottle, and I warmed it up with my hands a little bit, and it still was, I think, a little too cold, so... And it gives instructions for that, actually, on the bottle. Exactly what temperature you're supposed to drink it at, according to them and everything, so... Right. Of course, I couldn't find it now, could I? Fuck. Let's piss off. So 8.2%, 330 milliliter. Between 12 and 16 degrees Celsius. It's cool, I guess. Yeah, still getting a bit of that chili burn, though. Like, you know, I'm not saying that there's chilies in there, but damn, has it ever got heat in the end of this beer? Like, not heat, but like... The same kind of attack, but like that sharpness and that like acidity almost, you know? Like it's just like scorching your throat and shit. Like you're yelling almost. Yeah, but a nice licorice note has kind of taken over the pruniness kind of in the finish. I would say it's still a bit of pruniness there, a little bit of plum skin. Plum skin, kind of a pruny plum thing. But not so much plum, more prune. That's what I mean to say. Like more, no, sorry, I got it backwards. More plum, not prune. Like the fresh fruit, like the skin, that sour tartness a little bit. A little bit of that with some licorice. A lot of coffee. And, yeah, I would say, I would associate that burn as being like a red hot, those little red chilies. Something real freaking powerful. I don't know what the names of those ones are. I think they're just chili like an Asian pepper. I think they use them a lot in Thailand. They're just really small. Maybe about that long. And they'll blow your head off. I can't remember what the name of them is, though. Damn. Yeah, the more it warms up, it's more turning plum into prune and with, like, licorice. A little bit of molasses, maybe. A slight kind of a sweet-tasting kind of spot near the end, but this is definitely dry. Yeah, it seems a little bit boozy for 8.2. Like, you're definitely picking up the alcohol. But like I say, as it warms up, the whole thing just mellows out. Like, I'm getting less alcohol as before. There's still that mega burn in the intestines, but not as much carbonation or anything that, obviously. Well, I do enjoy it a lot for Imperial. I think because it doesn't have a whole lot of pruniness and raisininess, and it's not overkill in that aspect, so I'm definitely a fan whenever that happens. But it is quite dry. There's a lot of flavors, but it's like the chili heat's kind of like that scorchiness. There's not any like really big full flavors, you know. Then I'm bitching about there not being the pruniness and the plumminess hypocritically or whatever, but it's like so all the flavors are kind of, they're strong, but they're not big and like fatty and shit. Like, they're not really robust flavors, you know. Like, you know, they're very sharp and acidic flavors. Pretty smooth mouthfeel to the beer until it goes down, and like I would almost bet that there's some type of spice and some type of pepper, like whether it's ground pepper or whether it's an actual chili pepper in here. I would almost flat out say, damn, if it doesn't have that, it's definitely coming off like it does. Like, with that burn when your stomach and your intestines burn from the beer, I'm like, holy shit, I don't see that as carbon. If it's not, that's like some crazy amount of stout grains or something in there. A little bit of dark sediment in the glass. Other than that, that's the only spice, though. It's just that sharp chili heat. There's not really any other type of spice associations I get out of it. Yeah, a little bit of chocolate now that it's warming up. It's kind of almost getting like almost like a milk chocolate. Very smooth. The beer is getting a lot smoother up front. So definitely check this one out. I think it's definitely worth doing. I think in 9.25, 9.5 before. I'd say it's creeping up to a 10. I'd say 9.75 as it is right now. Maybe a 10 because it is. I am really enjoying it. I'm having a hard time giving it 11, right? But it's. I think it would be around a 9, between a 9 and a 10 for most beer snobs that tried this. So. Definitely a nice experience. A different tasting beer. It's pretty good. Recommend it. I'd pick it up again. Pretty good. It's definitely a tad on the expensive side. That's why I wouldn't, because it's only 330 mil and I'm going to keep tasting, but it's definitely the kind of beer that you might really like this because of that heat and it is different with the burn and stuff. So definitely give it a shot being so freaking different and shit, you know what I'm saying? So Berserker, maybe check it in, comment, rate, and subscribe and shit. Let's get this fucking shit rolling. Fucking blue coat motherfucking shit. Let's do it. Yeah!